Hello, I'm Hazel, and I would like to talk about the subject of perseverance. You know, there was a song that was popular in the 70s that said that what the world needs now is love, sweet love. No, what the world needs now is discipline, sweet discipline, because so many people are not disciplined about what they need to do. I have had to be disciplined because of the lifestyle that I chose. Number one, I wanted to have a big family. I wound up with 5 children. Actually, I had 6. My first one was stillborn, unfortunately, and was told I probably could never have children. Ha ha! I fooled them. I had 5 more after that, and the last ones were twins. And I loved it. I loved being a mom. I loved all of the things that we did together. But we were very determined that the children learn music. So at age 5, I started teaching each one of the children, and I insisted that they practice. And they did very well and performed. Our family performed as a family, singing and playing on stage from the time my oldest daughter was 11, my son was 9, and the next one was 3, and the twins were 2. We were on stage performing at all kinds of things in the local area of Lander, Wyoming, a very small area. But we didn't just stay in Lander. We went to the other towns around and were performing. But I insisted that the children practice, and we had a schedule. We had to take turns because there were all of us playing the piano. I eventually got another piano. It was 2. And then eventually I got a 3rd piano, a grand piano that I kept in the living room. And that way, 2 at least could practice at once. People would ask me, how do you get your children to do that? And I said, well, I tell them to. I expected my children to obey. It just was a matter of obedience. And they were very perseverant. When my twins were 11, they decided they wanted a paper route. Well, actually, the boy decided he wanted a paper route, but the girl was not going to be outdone, so she wanted a paper route too, and it was the Denver Post that they were delivering up there in this little Wyoming town. And I said, are you sure you really want to do this? Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Well, this was August. That year, we had 220 inches of snow. Those kids did not miss a day. They were not sick. They did not have a cold. The whole winter. I think getting out that early morning cold air helped them to stay healthy. But I would go to the indoor-outdoor thermometer and check it every morning. And if it was 25 below or warmer, they had to go by themselves on their bicycles. If it was 26 below, they could wake up their dad and their brother, and each one of them would take them. And that was the benchmark. 25 below was the mark. And below zero, we're talking about, folks. I know that sounds cruel, but you know what? It was their paper route. And I had told them before, this is your route. They had snowshoes and snow boots and snow suits, and they were very well taken care of. And they came home to a very hot breakfast, biscuits and gravy and bacon and eggs and a hot breakfast before they went to school. So perseverance has been a part of my life, and I tried to make it a part of their life. And when my son told me how to do exercises when I was about 52 years old, I've been perseverant. I've done it every day since then. And that is just what it takes to get good at anything, is to do it every day. And people are oftentimes reluctant about that. But you can't get good at something unless you practice it. And so perseverance has been a part of my life all along. And when I was introduced to this whole food nutrition, I was not going to do it. I said, I'm okay. I take vitamins. I exercise every day, and I'm okay. But my friend kept urging me to try it and urging me. And One day, she finally said, I said, vitamins, I would take them. She said, vitamins have never been shown to cure a disease or to prevent one. So why are you wasting your money with vitamins? And I thought about that for a while, but finally I decided one day when she called me, said, you must be pretty healthy or you wouldn't be able to do all the things that you're doing now. Because I was teaching 50 to 60 students a week. They came twice a week, half an hour for a private lesson, 40 minutes for a group lesson. And I had a recital at my house every month. And I went to the national conference for a week every year, and I went to the state conference for another week, and I was an officer in three music organizations, and we had festivals on the weekends, and I just was, I would get up every morning, teaching every morning at 6 a.m., Monday through Friday, and then I would have some time during the day, but 6 o'clock was when I started. So she said, you must be pretty healthy, but you know what? How long do you think you can keep that pace up? Well, I was already into my 80s, and I thought, well, maybe I should listen. Maybe I should do it. And so I decided to take the product. And guess what? I had more energy, and I was a regular girl for the first time in my life. I was so thrilled about that. And as time went on, I noticed my hands didn't get cold in the wintertime like they used to. And my feet stayed warm, which showed circulation. My fingernails quit being ridged. They were smooth. I noticed all kinds of good things happening. And I started sharing it with my students because they were sick with allergies and all kinds of things happening to them. And they could get off their allergy medicine in 1 month. And the mother's cholesterol dropped 100 points. And I thought, wow, there must be something to this. I'd never studied nutrition. I'd never studied anything, really, except the Bible and music. But my lifestyle had always been to eat fruits and vegetables. I'd never bought into the fast food idea. And so I didn't realize how poor everybody's life, how poor nutrition everyone had in their lifestyle. And when I began to realize that and share it, I found that they too could benefit. So it's Juice Plus is not something that you just take because you want to. You really need to take it to save your life and to give your life a full, as much energy as you possibly can have, and just be, in general, well-balanced and well-nourished. We don't want to be the best in the world. We just want to be the best for the world. If you would like to know more about this, give me a call at 720-810-6161. This is Hazel, and goodbye for now.